Well, thank you, Albert, very much. And I'd like to echo Albert's comments and Ed's comments and all of us up here in thanking you so much for participating in this international roundtable. And also, I guess we all want to thank you for participating in this, which is our 94th annual convention and exposition. So that's a tradition we're very, very proud of. And this is also the ninth time we've had this international roundtable session. So in some ways, this has become our own automotive industry Davos, World Economic Forum, although without the Alps and without the skiing. But we do have, of course, beautiful San Francisco, and we have a Golden Gate Bridge here, and beautiful weather that we've enjoyed through the course of the weekend. This is a tradition that we're very, very proud of, and it's particularly enjoyable when it's in an international city like San Francisco, and appropriate to being in an international city like this, as I think you've heard from Ed and others, that we believe we have some 1,500, more than 1,500 international dealers and dealer representatives here, representing some 36 countries. And it's very, very appropriate that we do have that, because the world, of course, is only getting smaller with ever-increasing communication, ever-increasing facility and transportation to get back and forth. And it's critical that we, as the retail automobile industry, communicate with one another and share what's going on in our respective countries. I think that's, we want to share best practices, but beyond that, I think we also want to share the what's going on with the manufacturers, what's going on with our governments in our various countries. The manufacturers, of course, are increasingly global with factories in countries around the world, but their executives also are moving from country to country. And we have many examples of that you've seen through the course of even this convention. And of course, their initiatives, the manufacturer initiatives, move across borders, move from country to country. And the government side, which I find myself most engaged in, is also quite true that our governments are increasingly communicating back and forth with one another about mobility initiatives, which impact us. They're talking about safety initiatives, which impact us. They talk about environmental global climate issues that impact us very much. So one perhaps takeaway I might suggest from this meeting for all of us, and I think we talked about it last year, is that we kind of redouble our efforts, rededicate ourselves to communicating with government within our countries, educating government within our countries about how our business works. It's something we've made it very much an initiative at NADA, and we found that you cannot over-communicate with government about how our business works. They don't understand it sufficiently. And so what we want to do is make sure we do everything we can to explain our business model. We also want to explain to government the challenges we face as an industry. And then very, very importantly, I think, is to reiterate repeatedly to government how important our industry is to local and national economies. Huge part of the local and national economies, our industry, and we should be proud of that, and we should brag on it and make sure government appreciates that. So hopefully you have found these exchanges that we've had over the past 9 years, this roundtable, to be valuable. We have also sought to, through Albert, to visit in many of your countries more than we have in the past, and you've come here, and I want to, on behalf of all of us, thank you for the courtesies that you've extended to us when we've made those visits. And perhaps, and this is something I talked to a couple of you about during the coffee break, we should look at some way to further institutionalize or regularize these communications, whether that's a more tangible organization, international organization, such as the manufacturers have through the AWICA process, which I know many of you are familiar with, involved in that, or whether it's more a web-based social networking type of regularized communication. We don't know, but that's something we should look at increasingly as we're coming out of this trough that we have been in. At the minimum, I hope you all will come to our next international roundtable at our next convention, which is in Las Vegas. Las Vegas doesn't have a Golden Gate Bridge, but it does have a lot of other attractions, and it certainly gets an international constituency there. So we do hope we will see you there. And again, a very sincere thank you for all that you've done and for being here with us. Just to finish with my Davos analogy, they kind of finished their conference by saying that the light at the end of the tunnel is getting brighter and brighter, and I hope that's the case for all of you in your countries. And again, thank you for being here.